welcome to another episode of TSC Friday. And today is going to be a first for me. I'm actually going to be driving a steam loco. It's going to be a first for a number of things. I'm going to be driving a steam loco for the first time in Train Sim Classic. Yeah, where have I been all this time? I know. I've had loads of them, but I've never driven them before. Always put them in my own scenarios. And I'm actually going to be driving it with an Xbox controller, mouse and keyboard. So I have all three. And going to be driving the Flying Scotsman. So I did receive a key for the Flying Scotsman's centenary pack from Dovetail. So a big thank you for them. And yes, I've only just got around to using it. But yeah, so this is either going to go well or it's going to go horribly wrong. Ah, dear. So yeah. So good morning, driver. This is like your first day on the job sort of thing. Good morning, driver. Today you'll be taking this special run with the Flying Scotsman from London King's Cross up the East Coast Main Line. Please allow the final passengers to board here at King's Cross ahead of our booked 7:05 departure. Remember, our maximum permissible speed is 75 miles an hour. I'm only taking this as far as Stevenage, if I remember. Yeah, unfortunately, you'll probably hear police sirens, anything going on, and roadworks, because they're all rebuilding the road outside my house. So I have some windows open. I need air, and some windows are closed. So yeah, you'll hear all sorts of noises and everything. So yeah, here goes. Wish me luck. Right. So. Put my headlights on. I have to say, I don't like this view of King's Cross. I prefer the train sim world thingy. But this is my train. And I'm just going to do 8 view. Just move her around. Get a nice shot. This is the... There's a network staff, it should be there. Right. Cancel. I might get a knock at the door as well at some point. Right. So, I've already done the job where we... where we do our we drop back on with the support coach and everything. So yeah. No Deltics here, I'm afraid. It's all unskinned 800s. So, it's a nice station. Personally, I prefer a run up the East Coast Main Line, or West Coast Main Line, but there you go. Did they have platform 9 3/4 though? That's what you need to ask. And where the hell am I? There we go. All I got is that Harry Potter song, the music in my head. It's platform 8. We don't even have platform 9 3/4, come on. Okay, where have I gone? Whether they'd be allowed to put that in there, because it's probably copyright. Oh, no. It's just, because I kept pressing shift button. I hate that when that comes up. Stop doing that. Right, so passengers are quietly boarding. Leave my specs for the PC in the description. So, yeah. Right, I'll just let that carry on. So you'll hear the odd doink going off, beep going off, because that's a Discord server. I can't even shut it off, even when it's not in use. So, yeah. So I'm learning the controls of an Xbox controller. I have a Turtle Beach controller. I have a green LED controller somewhere, and I've no idea where it is. I used to use it. Brilliant it was. All wired in, USB, you should just plug in, but yeah, I can't seem to find it, so. Right. So we're not far off. Information about the history of the Flying Scotsman. Flying Scotsman was built in Doncaster, the first locomotive of the newly formed London North Eastern Railway LNR, 1923. It's left the works 24th of February 1923 with the number 1472. It was designed by Sir Nigel Gresley as part of the A1 class, the most powerful locomotive used by the LNR at that time. That was that it. Right. Yeah, we just done that. By 1924, when it was selected to appear at the British Empire Exhibition in London, the loco had been renumbered to 4472. It was also, this time, given the name Flying Scotsman. This was reference to the named daily 10 o'clock London to Edinburgh departure from King's Cross, which started in 1862. Oh, man, I just think I heard someone at the door. Bear with me. This is what happens when you're a carer and everything. Right, this has that. We'll try and edit that out. So, yeah. Right. Right, we're ready to go. Brakes off, put her in first. I always say put her in first, don't worry. Seven-mile run to Stevenage. Thank you. I've got to remember my AWS as well. I can't see anything. It won't allow me to look outside the cab. So we're coming under the St Pancras High Speed 1, and then the North London line. Thank you. just realised what I had to do is trains in world, like bring it back, bring the regulator back 25%. There we go. And I was thinking, why am I using so much thingy? And it's just like I had the regulator open too wide. Should be okay now. Whether we make it to Stevenage on time with water or not, I don't know. What, 25 miles? I'm not sure. We're only at Finchley Park. I think I'm doing it right. I think. Looks a bit yellow. Let's go, full steam ahead, hey! It was always the intrepidation of trying to drive, learn how to drive a steam loco. So, yeah. Part. Ali Pali coming up. Kids, you in the thingy, it's a Flying Scotsman. Beating these paths long before you were about. I am quite happy on the whistle, by the way. Miles, so we got a little bit of a trip on us. This is the Bounce Green Depot. Used to be home of the HSCs and now the home of the Supers. Get some cold in there, son. We seem to be doing okay. So we're going to arrive a little bit late. another 20, just under another 20 minutes to run. Hope you can hold on for that. Blast from the station. The other thing as well, what I find as well, is when you hear the coaches going over the tractors, the old clickety clack, the little vibration thingy in the controller emulates it. There's a smile on my face when I did this. So, yeah. I'm going to get hammered on the experience points for being late. This is where we've got our first speed reference, so it's there. Thank you. The other thing is as well, if you actually hear my voice echoing, it's a problem to do with the PC. I'm not exactly sure why, and I can't think why, but yeah. Lost where the Flying Scotsman is. Get them from up here, I think. Ah! Bloody keyboard thing. Wellwind Garden City. for us. If you are enjoying this video, give us a like, give us a sub, hit the sub button, and then make sure that you hit the bell icon so you can get notified when I go live, when I upload content of such videos like this, and also when I make community posts. So, yeah, hope you are enjoying it. Hints for better driving of steam locos? Give us a shout, let us know. Give it to. Oh, we got to slow down. Another 6 minutes, we should be we won't be going 125 miles an hour today, I'm afraid. Well, we're all done to give you a good squeeze to it as we go through. 5.6 miles. Oh, I've not, oops, a daisy. I've not acknowledged the AWS. I saw the signal flashing. Not that bad. Being a naughty boy. That's my fault because I'm more in awe of everything than like not going. Oh, that's a good run, I was enjoying that. Oh, Or you get penalised for the emergency brake application as well. Right, so we've got a green, I think, on both those. We're going so well. I've done it again. Because I'm out the cab, I don't hear the buzz. That's why. I just saw it come up there, I thought, ooh, yellow. So, it's fine, it's no worries. It's all a learning experience. It's the same principle as what it is on Trenton World. I may have to pause this for a couple of minutes. Taking on delivery. Not near it. I should be okay. I'm hoping I can finish this before. Infamous networks. Mm. 2.94 miles to go, and then yeah, we'll be at Stevenage, go through Nebworth, give him a two. It's a good job we're not stopping at Nebworth, isn't it? So we are going to be running a bit late, but that's just how it is. I'm driving, so I'm never going to be early on anything. About 1.5 miles. We don't have any upcoming speed issues. Quite well, I wanted to stop, but we should carry on with it. I was distracted by the faster fashion poster there. go. Excellent work, driver. Will now be held here at Stevenage to allow passengers and members of the public to take pictures. Not from that distance, they will be. You did well to keep the time. The East Coast Main Line is busy even on a Saturday, and it's important that we stick to our book times. The scenario continues in FSC-03-101-0705, London King's Cross to Leeds, Part 2, which we're not going to be doing just yet. So I hope you have enjoyed this, guys. Thank you all very much for watching. Yes, I had a couple of emergency thingy issues because I was outside the cab and I didn't hear the old AWS warning thing go off. And I'm kind of, I don't think that if I was driving like I am with 4,300 odd gallons of water left, I don't think I'd get there with that amount of water, supposedly. So yeah, but guys, thank you all very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed it. Leave a comment, let me know what you think. What was I doing wrong? And I think I know what I did wrong at first, is that I had the regulator 100% open. Should have really brought it back to 25%, I think it is, which I did remember in the end, but it's cost me a lot of pressure and everything and in timing, hence one of the reasons why I was late. So yeah, anyway, hopefully I'll catch you again in another episode of TSC Fridays. Hope you've enjoyed this. Leave the like button, or hit the like button if you have. Hit the sub button if you haven't, if you're not a sub, not a subscriber. You'll get notified when I go live, when I do uploads like this, and also community posts as well. This was my first ever time driving a steam locomotive on Train Sim Classic. And it was the first ever time driving the Flying Scotsman as well. So, a bit of a prestigious loco. I know it's flying money pit to some people. Some people love it. It's a bit like Marmite, isn't it? You love it, you hate it. Bit Vegemite-y, Marmite-y, you know? Or peanut butter, if you like that sort of thing. But, yeah, it's been really enjoyable. Been a bit of a learning experience in that. So, hopefully be driving some more steam locos in the future. I don't know. If that's what you want me to do, if you want to see me driving more steam locos, let us know. It won't always be Scotsman, sorry. But yeah, big thank you to Dovetail for the provision of the key as well. Thank you for them. And yeah, guys, I will hopefully see you in the next one. So thank you all very much. Final destination is least. And we're back to the front end. How did we do? Oh, I've got 1,000. That's okay. That's good. I've upped my XP total. Yay! So we will probably end up doing London King's Cross to Leeds Part 2. And I think there's Part 3 as well. So, yeah, we'll do them at some point. But, yeah, guys, thank you all very much. Really hope you have enjoyed it. If so, leave a like as well. But anyway, thanks all. And I'll speak to you later. Bye-bye.